Exalt, let them exalt the hosts of heaven. Exalt, let angel ministers of God exalt. Let the trumpet of salvation sound aloud our mighty King's triumph. Be glad, let earth be glad as glory floods her, ablaze with the light from her eternal King. Let all corners of the earth be glad, knowing an end to gloom and darkness. Rejoice, let Mother Church also rejoice, arrayed with the lightning of his glory. Let this holy building shake with joy, filled with the mighty voices of the peoples. Therefore, dearest friends, standing in the awesome glory of this holy light, invoke with me, I ask you, the mercy of God Almighty, that he who has been pleased to number me, though unworthy, among the Levites, may pour into me his light unshadowed, that I may sing this candle's perfect praises. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, with ardent love of mind and heart, and with devoted service of our voice, to acclaim our God invisible, the Almighty Father, and Jesus Christ our Lord, his Son, his only begotten, who for our sake paid Adam's debt to the eternal Father, and pouring out his own dear blood, wiped clean the record of our ancient sinfulness. These then are the feasts of Passover, in which is slain the Lamb, the one true Lamb, whose blood anoints the doorposts of believers. This is the night when once you led our forebears, Israel's children, from slavery in Egypt, and made them pass dry shod through the Red Sea. This is the night that with a pillar of fire banished the darkness of sin. This is the night that even now throughout the world sets Christian believers apart from worldly vices and from the gloom of sin, leading them to grace and joining them to his holy ones. This is the night when Christ broke the prison bars of death and rose victorious from the underworld. Our birth would have been no gain had we not been redeemed. Oh, wonder of your humble care for us, O love, O charity beyond all telling, to ransom a slave, you gave away your Son. O truly necessary sin of Adam, destroyed completely by the death of Christ. Oh, how happy fault that earns so great, so glorious a Redeemer. Oh, truly blessed night, worthy alone to know the time and hour when Christ rose from the underworld. This is the night of which it is written, the night shall be as bright as day. Dazzling is the night for me, and full of gladness. The sanctifying power of this night dispels wickedness, washes faults away, restores innocence to the fallen, and joy to mourners, drives out hatred, fosters concord, and brings down the mighty. On this your night of grace, O Holy Father, accept this candle, a solemn offering, the work of bees and of your servant's hands, an evening sacrifice of praise, this gift from your most holy church. But now we know the praises of this pillar, which glowing fire ignites for God's honor, a fire into many flames divided, yet never dimmed by the sharing of its light. For it is fed by melting wax, drawn out by mother bees, to build a torch so precious. Oh, truly blessed night, when things of heaven are wed to those of earth, and divine to the human. Therefore, O Lord, we pray you, that this candle, hallowed to the honor of your name, may persevere undimmed to overcome the darkness of this night. Receive it as a pleasing fragrance, and let it mingle with the lights of heaven. May this flame be found still burning by the morning star, the one morning star who never sets, Christ your Son, who coming back from death's domain has shed his peaceful light on humanity and lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, now that we have begun our solemn vigil, let us listen with quiet hearts to the word of God. Let us meditate on how God come in times past, saved his people, and in these, the last days, has sent his Son as our Redeemer. Let our prayer, that God may complete this paschal work of salvation by the fullness of redemption.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless wasteland, and darkness covered the abyss, while a mighty wind swept over the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw how good the light was. God then separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and darkness he called night. Thus evening came, and morning followed, the first day. Then God said, "Let there be a dome in the middle of the waters to separate one body of water from the other. And so it happened. God made the dome, and it separated the water above from the dome from the water below it. God called the dome the sky. Evening came, and morning followed, the second day. Then God said, "Let the water under the sky be gathered into a single basin, so that the dry land may appear. And so it happened. The water under the sky was gathered into its basin, and the dry land appeared. God called the dry land the earth, and the basin of the water he called the sea. God saw how good it was. Then God said, "Let the earth bring forth vegetation, every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on earth that bears fruit with its seeds in it." And so it happened. The earth brought forth every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on earth that bears fruit with its seed in it. God saw how good it was. Evening came, and morning followed, the third day. Then God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate day from night. Let them mark the fixed times, the days and the years, and serve as luminaries in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth." And so it happened. God made the two great lights, the greater one to govern the day and the lesser one to govern the night. And he made the stars. God sent them into the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. God saw how good it was. Evening came, and morning followed, the fourth day. Then God said, "Let the water teem with an abundance of living creatures, and on the earth let birds fly beneath the dome of the sky." And so it happened. God created the great sea monsters and all kinds of swimming creatures with which the water teems, and all kinds of winged birds. God saw how good it was, and God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile, multiply, and fill the water of the seas, and let the birds multiply on the earth." Evening came, and morning followed, the fifth day. Then God said, "Let the earth bring forth all kinds of living creatures, cattle, creeping things, and wild animals of all kinds." And so it happened. God made all kinds of wild animals, all kinds of cattle, and all kinds of creeping things of the earth. God saw how good it was. Then God said, "Let us make man in our image, after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and the cattle, and over all the wild animals and all the creatures that crawl on the ground." God created man in his image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and all the living things that move on the earth." God also said, "See, I give you every seed-bearing plant all over the earth, and every tree that has seed-bearing fruit on it to be your food. And to all the animals of the land, all the birds of the air, and all the living creatures that crawl on the ground, I give all the green plants for food." And so it happened. God looked at everything he had made, and he found it very good. Evening came, and morning followed, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth and all their array were completed. Since on the seventh day God was finished with the work he had been doing, he rested on the seventh day from all the work he had undertaken. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Bless the Lord, O my soul.
Bless the Lord, O my soul.
O Lord, my God, you are great indeed. You are clothed with majesty and glory, robed in light as with a cloak. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. You fixed the earth upon its foundation, not to be moved forever. With the ocean as with a garment, you covered it. Above the mountains, the water stood. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. You send forth springs into the watercourses that wind among the mountains. Beside them, the birds of heaven dwell, for among the branches they send forth a song. Lord, send out your spirit
and renew the face of the earth.
You water the mountains from your palace. The earth is replete with the fruits of your works. You raise grass for the cattle and vegetation for man's use, producing bread from the earth.
Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth.
How manifold are your works, O Lord. In wisdom you have wrought them all. The earth is full of your creatures. Bless the Lord, O my soul.
Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who are wonderful in the ordering of all your works, may those you have redeemed understand that there exists nothing more marvelous than the world's creation in the beginning, except that, at the end of the ages, Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Why are you crying out to me? Tell the Israelites to go forward, and you, lift up your staff, and with hand outstretched over the sea, split the sea in two, that the Israelites may pass through it on dry land. But I will make the Egyptians so obstinate that they will go in after them. Then I will receive glory through Pharaoh and all his army, his chariots and charioteers. The Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord, when I receive glory through Pharaoh and his chariots and charioteers." The angel of God, who had been leading Israel's camp, now moved and went around behind them, the column of cloud also, leaving the front, took up its place behind them, so that it came between the camp of the Egyptians and that of Israel. But the cloud now became dark, and thus the night passed without the rival camps coming any closer together all night long. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord swept the sea with a strong east wind throughout the night, and so turned it into dry land. When the water was thus divided, the Israelites marched into the midst of the sea on dry land, with the water like a wall to their right and to their left. The Egyptians followed in pursuit. All Pharaoh's horses and chariots and charioteers went after them, right into the midst of the sea. In the night watch, just before dawn, the Lord cast through the column of the fiery cloud upon the Egyptian force, a glance that threw it into a panic. And he so clogged their chariot wheels that they could hardly drive. With that, the Egyptians sounded the retreat before Israel, because the Lord was fighting for them against the Egyptians. Then the Lord told Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea, that the water may flow back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and their charioteers." So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and at dawn, the sea flowed back into its normal depth. The Egyptians were fleeing head-on toward the sea when the Lord heard them, hurled them into its midst. As the water flowed back, it covered the chariots and the charioteers of Pharaoh's whole army, which he had followed the Israelites into the sea. Not a single one of them escaped. But the Israelites had marched on dry land through the midst of the sea, with the water like a wall to their right and to their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel on that day from the power of the Egyptians. When Israel saw the Egyptians lying dead on the seashore and beheld the great power that the Lord had shown against the Egyptians, they feared the Lord and believed in him and in his servant Moses. Then Moses and the Israelites sang this song to the Lord: "I will sing to the Lord, for he is gloriously triumphant. Horse and chariot he has cast into the sea." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory.
Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory.
I will sing to the Lord, for he is glorious, triumphant. Horse and chariot he has cast into the sea. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and he has been my Savior. He is my God. I praise him. The God of my father, I extol him. Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory. The Lord is a warrior. Lord is his name. Pharaoh's chariots and army he hurled into the sea. The elite of his officers were submerged in the Red Sea. Let us sing to the Lord.
He has covered himself in glory.
The flood waters covered them. They sank into the depths like a stone. Your right hand, O Lord, magnificent in power, your right hand, O Lord, has shattered the enemy.
Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory.
You brought in the people you redeemed and planted them on the mountain of your inheritance, the place where you made your seat, O Lord, the sanctuary, Lord, which your hands established. The Lord shall reign forever and ever.
Let us sing to the Lord. He has covered himself in glory. Let us pray. O God, whose ancient wonders remain undimmed in splendor even in our day, for what you once bestowed on a single people, freeing them from Pharaoh's persecution by the power of your right hand, now you bring about the salvation of the nations through the waters of rebirth. Grant, we pray, that the whole world may become children of Abraham and inherit the dignity of Israel's birthright. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord came to me, saying, "Son of man, when the house of Israel lived in their land, they defiled it by their conduct and deeds. Therefore I poured out my fury upon them, because of the blood they had poured out on the ground, and because they defiled it with idols. I scattered them among the nations, dispersing them over foreign lands. According to their conducts and deeds, I judged them. But when they came among the nations, wherever they came, they served to profane my holy name. Because it was said of them, "These are the people of the Lord," yet they had to leave their land. So I have relented because of my holy name, which the house of Israel profaned among the nations where they came. Therefore, say to the house of Israel, "Thus says the Lord, not for your sakes do I act, house of Israel, but for the sake of my holy name, which you profaned among the nations to which you came. I will prove the holiness of my great name profaned among the nations, in whose midst you have profaned it. Thus the nations shall know that I am the Lord, says the Lord God. Would in their sight I prove my holiness through you? For I will take you away from among the nations, gather you from all the foreign lands, and bring you back to your land. I will sprinkle clean water upon you to cleanse you from all your impurities, and from all your idols I will cleanse you. I will give you a new heart and place a new spirit within you, taking from your bodies your stony hearts and giving you natural hearts. I will put my spirit within you and make you live by my statutes, careful to observe my decrees. You shall live in the land I gave your fathers. You shall be my people, and I will be your God." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
A clean heart create for me, O God, and a steadfast spirit renew within me. Cast me not from your presence, and your Holy Spirit take not from me. Create a clean heart in me, O God. Give me back the joy of your salvation, and a willing spirit sustain in me. I will teach transgressors your ways, and sinners shall return to you.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
For you are not pleased with sacrifices. Should I offer a holocaust, you would not accept it. My sacrifice, O God, is a contrite spirit. A heart contrite and humbled, O God, you will not spurn.
Create a clean heart in me, O God. Let us pray. O God of unchanging power and eternal light, look with favor on the wondrous mystery of the whole church, and serenely accomplish the work of human salvation, which you plan for all eternity. May the whole world know and see that what was cast down is raised up, what had become old is made new, and all things are restored to integrity through Christ, just as by him they came into being, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest. Sing glory to God. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth.
Glory to God in the highest, sing glory to God. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth.
Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you. We give you thanks, we praise you for your glory.
Glory to God in the highest, sing glory to God. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth.
Lord Jesus Christ, Lord God, Lamb of God. You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer.
Let us pray. O God, who make this most sacred night radiant with the glory of Christ's resurrection, stir up in your church a spirit of adoption, so that, renewed in body and mind, we may render you undivided service through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. For we have grown into union with him through a death like his. We shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin, for a dead person has been absolved from sin. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as being dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia,
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven, approached, rolled back the stone, and sat upon it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing was white as snow. The guards were shaken with fear of him and became dead like dead men. Then the angel said to the woman in reply, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are seeking Jesus the crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised, just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, he has been raised from the dead, and he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him. Behold, I have told you." Then they went away quickly from the tomb, fearful yet overjoyed, and ran to announce this to the disciples. And behold, Jesus met them on their way and greeted him. They approached, embraced his feet, and did him homage. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Happy Easter, everyone. I know that it certainly is a very different Easter for all of us. I've been thinking a lot about Easter in general, and I came to realize that it was right around this time last year that I had received the phone call from Bishop de Cunha asking me to assume the pastorate of the three former parishes, now one unified parish, parishes of St. Mary, Sacred Heart, and St. Mark. And I have to admit, I was very overwhelmed. I knew that my life was going to change. I don't think a year ago any of us would have envisioned how all of our lives have completely and utterly changed. But I was fearful, if you will. I knew that this was going to be a huge responsibility. I was going to be assuming an extremely large assignment. Obviously, I was comforted by the fact that I would have Father Jack and Deacon Joe. I knew I was inheriting, if you will, a very competent staff. But I was still overwhelmed. I was very comfortable in Dartmouth. It was a shaking. It was kind of like that earthquake that we hear in today's gospel. And so the journey began on the 26th of June. And a lot has changed. Our community has changed. Our church has changed. Our town has changed. Our commonwealth has changed. Our world has changed. I don't know when we will begin living something normal again. I don't have a crystal ball and they don't work anyway. But I know that in time, we will resume some semblance of normalcy. And on Easter, as we gather to celebrate the resurrection of Jesus from the dead, that joy, despite it might looking very different, has not been lessened or cheapened. Actually, I have a funny feeling that more people feel closer to, yes, the crucified Lord, but hopefully as these days of Easter joy enshroud us, we will allow him to be that guiding light that gives us a sense of hope. Obviously, a lot of things needed to be adapted when I first arrived, and we spent many evenings with our catechists, with our director of faith formation. There was one night, and I think both Father Jack and I were a bit frazzled and just overwhelmed. It was a late August evening, and We had gotten home rather late from a lengthy meeting, and I hadn't prepared anything for supper, and we didn't have anything really that we could call a meal in the refrigerator. So Father Jack said to me, he said, "What about takeout from Kwan's?" And I said, "What's Kwan's?" And he said, "You've never heard of Kwan's yet?" He said, "You've been here for almost 2 months. You've never heard of Kwan's? What do you mean?" I said, "I'm guessing it's a Chinese restaurant." And he said, "Yes, it's a Chinese restaurant. So I like Chinese food, but my problem is I like all the bad stuff on the menu. Father Jack will eat all of the healthy stuff. I want all the fried stuff, the artery clogging stuff." So Father Jack, I downloaded a menu. I picked one of my combination platters, and he dutifully went off and collected our supper. And what do you get so that you can enjoy at the end of your Chinese meal? A fortune cookie. Well, I can tell you that I have been here in North Attleboro since June, and last Sunday was the second time, Palm Sunday, was the second time I ate food from Kwan's. They were very nice. They even gave us an extra cookie, and I had to hide it because I didn't want Father Jack to eat it on me because I knew I was going to use it. Each time I have eaten Chinese food from Kwan's, at the end of my meal, I have opened my fortune cookie. As God is my witness, and I have an eyewitness sitting in front of me, so I'm not exaggerating or lying in any way, shape, or form, I have kept my two fortunes because they are very telling. The first one that I opened after that very lengthy meeting, all things have an end. Needless to say, I laughed at that time, and I said that I was going to laminate it and keep it on my desk forever and ever. It's taken on a different meaning now. The second fortune cookie from Palm Sunday says the following: "The harder the conflict, the more glorious the triumph." Talk about getting lucky twice. We know that eventually this pandemic will be under control. Our world has seen pandemics in the past. We have not experienced anything like it in our lifetime. But this too will come to an end. All things come to an end. But as we struggle, whether that be spiritually, economically, because maybe you've been furloughed, you no longer have a job for the time being, perhaps you are going stir crazy in your house as parents are trying to balance work, teaching their kids from home remotely, and trying to find that balance of peace and prayer. Whether that is physically, perhaps you are ill. Perhaps you watching right now, maybe you do have COVID-19. The harder the conflict, the more glorious the triumph. That's exactly what we do today. When that Alleluia was played and we sang it, it reminded me of his words. He is risen. And one of the first words he says after his resurrection, I proclaim them from Matthew's gospel: "Do not be afraid." This Easter, there is no reason for us to be afraid, because all things do come to an end. And we know that in this hard conflict, during this time of great difficulty, our triumph at the end of it is going to be something glorious and remarkable. I've said it before and I will say it again. This is going to change us in ways that we can't even imagine. And I think that some of those ways, well, strike that, most of those ways are going to be very positive. We've already seen the fruits of keeping a distance, working remotely. It's not always easy. When was the last time you had a hug? Somebody sent me a spiritual hug the other day. It's not the same. Life is different. But all things come to an end. And this hard conflict that we're dealing with right now will make us a glorious and victorious people who shout from the tops of our homes, "Resurrexit sicut dixit. He is risen as he said." And with that, dear brothers and sisters, happy Easter. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water he has created, which will be sprinkled upon us as a memorial of our baptism. May he generously renew us, that we may remain faithful to the Spirit whom we have received. Lord our God, in your mercy, be present to your people, who keep vigil on this most sacred night, and for all of us who recall the wondrous work of our creation and the still greater work of our redemption, graciously bless this water. For you created water to make the fields fruitful and to refresh and cleanse our bodies. You also made water the instrument of your mercy, for through water you freed your people from slavery and quench their thirst in the desert. Through water, the prophets proclaim the new covenant you were to enter with the human race. And at last, through water, which Christ made holy in the Jordan, you have renewed our corrupted nature in the bath of regeneration. Therefore, may this water be for us a memorial of the baptism we have received, and grant that we may share in the gladness of our brothers and sisters who have been baptized through Christ our Lord. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so, now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, those here present with me and those watching at home, do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin? Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. Confident that God always hears the prayers of his faithful, we turn to him, asking that he hear and answer our prayers.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. That the whole church in this Easter season feel the enthusiasm of the first Christians spreading the good news. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all in positions of authority be the yeast that transforms society and heals our fragile earth. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all Christians, women and men, bear witness to the resurrected Christ in all that they say and do. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our community, nation, and indeed the entire world, struggling in any way, physically, emotionally, or economically, be given the strength and support that they need during this time of global epidemic. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those on the front lines combating COVID-19, especially healthcare professionals and first responders, know that gratitude we have for them for their valiant efforts. May they be kept safe from all harm and have the rest they need to be strengthened for the challenge they faced. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Catholic community of North Attleboro at Transfiguration of the Lord Parish turn to the divine physician for the help needed to truly be a people of hope. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who celebrate the Lord's rising from the dead and who spiritually share in receiving his body and blood recognize him in one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our loved ones who have died rest in the peace of God's kingdom. And we remember in a special way at this Mass the members of the Catholic community of North Attleboro. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the needs we hold in our hearts will be lovingly answered by God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Most merciful Father, on this most sacred of days, we turn to you, asking that you hear and answer our prayers, if they be in accord with your plan. For it is with faith in the risen Son, whose name we truly profess to be Lord and King, now and forever. Amen. Amen. At this time during Mass, as if we were normally together, it would be past the basket time. And obviously, people have been so very generous by sending in their budget envelopes, by those especially at Sacred Heart Church who use NCS. If you are following us momentarily, a link to Gabriel Software will pop up where you can make a one-time donation to Transfiguration of the Lord Parish. Thank you for your support and your dedication to the ministry that we are trying to provide, albeit in a distanced way, but please know that Father Jack and I and the entire parish staff are grateful that we have not yet needed to furlough anyone. So thank you for your generosity.
Your living voice.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. And now, with a spirit of contrite hearts, may we be accepted by you, Lord, for my sacrifice in your sight. This day be a blessing to you, Lord God. Lord, wash away my iniquities and cleanse me of my sins.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at my hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Accept, we ask, O Lord, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that what has begun in the Paschal mysteries may, by the working of your power, bring us to the healing of eternity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this night above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, with the angelic host, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Edgar our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but look on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot, at this moment, receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Let us pray. Pour out on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness, make those you have nourished by this Paschal sacrament one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As our vigil comes to a close, I know that it certainly looked and felt different, but we were in this together. On behalf of Deacon Joe, who I'm grateful was here with us throughout the Triduum, on behalf of Father Jack, our entire parish staff that has continued to work, Mike and Jim have been disinfecting our churches, Monica and Jean have been diligently dealing with getting things out to people, answering the phone. I know that Mrs. Corvese is working remotely. But on behalf of our entire parish staff, and in my own name, I know that Easter is going to look and feel differently this year, but it's the same reality. He is risen as he said. Happy Easter. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia. Bow down for the blessing.
After each prayer, please respond by saying, Amen. May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion, defend you from every assault of sin.
Amen.
And may he, who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten Son, endow you with the prize of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you, who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal feast, come with Christ's help and exalting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.